In the press conference, official for the game. In the table is the coach Angus and the player Marvin Phillip for Trinidad and Tobago. So you gonna have a question, you can raise your hand and the person will give you the microphone.
Hello, Pilar Perez from ESPN International. Coach, what do you think is gonna be the biggest challenge against the USA? Thank you.
To start with the belief that we didn't start with against Jamaica. I think if you look for 30 minutes, we look shell shock. But I thought after that, in the second half of the game, I thought we settled in really nicely and we started to show ourselves.
Hi, Coach. In both games, you've seemed to have a rough start. The goals against St. Kitts came in the second half. Then against Jamaica, you just mentioned that you guys got better once the game like went further. Why is that? Why are you guys having trouble starting well?
There's a mystery we tried to solve. you know, the warm-up is good. You know, I think the preparation is good. Some of the mental preparation probably is not that good, maybe. So we take a little bit of time and we're trying to correct that. But I think, as you rightly said, our second half in the boat matches were excellent second halves. And in the Jamaica game, you know, we looked like we wanted to create a lot of stuff. We created a lot of chances without taking the opportunities. So, and in the St. Kitts game, that's when we really took over the game. But I thought that game, actually, the pitch didn't help us in the first half. Got a lot of water on it when we actually started the match. But yeah, we seem to have better second half than first half.
Kyle Bonner with ESPN. Coach, this is a U.S. team that has a lot of kind of second choice guys who are trying to earn their way, earn bigger opportunities with the national team. What has stood out about this group from watching the first two games?
Well, the hunger, the group. As you just said, these guys play for spots on the roster. So they're going to be a lot more hungry, actually, than the guys who actually normally start. So it's going to be a difficult game for us because they would want to prove themselves to the selectors and the coaches that they can be in the final squad.
Coach, just to follow on that question, this being not the best American team, do you favor your chances against this team?
I don't think the U.S. put out a team to lose. I think this team is very competitive. All of the players are playing in good teams in the MLS. You also have some of the trickling guys, the goalkeeper, it's playing in Europe. So it's not an easy team as people want to make it sound like. There's a reason that America is probably number one, two in the CONCACAF because they have depth. So they could lose some players and still perform at this level, you know.
Let me just direct a question to the athlete. You've been with the Trinidad and Tobago team for a long time. What does a victory for you against the United States mean?
A victory will definitely help us to move on to the stage of the tournament, you know. We have that in the back of our heads in saying that, you know, it's not going to be an easy game. We know it's going to be tough, but I think once we play to our full potential, we will get past the US and go on to the second round.
Is there a question to both of you? Please step with you on this. What would a victory mean for Trinidad and Tobago? We have of course beaten the USA already on October 10, 2017. What would a victory mean?
I know what it would mean for us, the players. I don't much know what it would mean for the country. But I know what it would mean for the players that would be because we came in 2021 after a failed World Cup campaign, we qualified. Our expectations there was to make the group stage because we're still in a rebuilding stage. So to qualify proper this time, and to try to get out of the group was the aim this time, and that will show some level of improvement as we go along. So we are very realistic in what we believe that we can do. Our football has been in turmoil for a number of years. This is the first year in about three that we actually have a league back home. So there's a lot of issues that we work in. Chuba is getting a lot more quiet, and the work has been seen on the back where we have been improving a lot. So now we want to make steps going forward every single time we play. So now we qualify back-to-back for the Gold Cup, making the group stage back-to-back. Now we want to see if we can come out, and that would signify progress.
It will be a significant feat to get over the US. You know, we have been battling from since, I think, inception 1989. You know, there is always a rivalry there, and so I think we getting over the US at this present point in time will only augur well for our football going forward.
Coach, what's the mood in the camp after losing the last game? The guys, what frame of mind are they?
The good thing about sport, you know, it's not like a war when they get shoot, you fall down and you die. You always have a second chance, so we have another game. So when you always have to look forward, you don't look back as much. You look retrospective at what happened, what we could have done better. But the mood is well, because we're in a difficult group. Nobody expects us to come onto the group. Nobody. So because the both teams that we're playing in the group are ranked higher than us, better quality player than us. So anything that we do is a bonus coming out of this group, because the both teams have 4 points, we have 3 points. We're still in it going into the last game, and I think that in itself is progress.
Any more questions? So that's the finish for the press conference. Thank you so much for the time, and good luck tomorrow in the scene again.
Thank you.